homeboy. It's starting to feel like summertime in downtown Cleveland, Ohio. Today, the Indians will try to take 3 out of 4 from the Baltimore Orioles. Yesterday, we watched Oscar Mercado, amid the falling raindrops, get his first major league hit. It was a double up the alley. That led to a run and helped the Indians to a 4-1 win over Baltimore. And so now today, the Indians go for a series win. Hi again, everyone. Matt Underwood alongside Rick Manning. Shane Bieber will get the start today for the Tribe. Started out great. First 3 starts, he's only given up 3 runs. Last 5 starts, he's given up 19 runs. And the home run ball, a career high, 4 home runs allowed his last time out. What does he need to do better today?
Well, you know what? The run support has been an issue for him, but he's got to come home. He hasn't won a ball game here. He hasn't won a ball game in a month. But with Shane Bieber, his numbers look better this year than they did last year. There's his 4-seam fastball on the outside part of the plate that he can ride high. A 2-seamer that tails away from the left-handed hitters. I mean, he has all the weapons. He's an aggressive guy. He throws a lot of strike. Here's his circle changeup, down and away. And then he's got the curveball and also a slider. But this curveball, nice bite to it. That's a knuckle curve. And then you'll see a slider. So Shane Bieber has all the pitches. No matter, right now you got to keep it in the yard. He's never faced the Baltimore Orioles before. This will be his first start. But when you look at the numbers, much better this year. Look at the right-handed hitters hitting less than 200 off him. Left-handers, he's really improved on that department. If they can get him a few runs early, I think he'll be fine today.
All right, we'll be back with the play-by-play coming up in just a bit. Alan Jensen are up next with the showstopper. Will the Minnesota Twins ever lose again?
Yes.
They're 30-15 to start the year. And we'll check in with Andre Knott, who has some thoughts on Shane Bieber coming up. Cleveland Indians baseball is brought to you by Who But W.B. Mason, the official office supplier of the Cleveland Indians. By your Northern Ohio Honda dealers, made in Ohio, Ohio proud. And by Spectrum Mobile. Spectrum Mobile has unlimited talk, text, and data. Save up to 40%. Go to SpectrumMobile.com today. Indians will try to make it 3 of 4 against the Baltimore Orioles this weekend. Game 4 in their 4-game set today. Coming up in just a few moments, that man, Shane Bieber, will throw out the first pitch on Sign Sunday here today. We've seen a lot of great signs as a young man. He's having a good time, and we are here in center field along with Jensen Lewis, Al Pawlowski. Great to have you along. A baseball team that's having a great time this year. They are the Minnesota Twins.
Boo.
That's our showstopper for today. They are 30-15 now. They won again last night. They blew out the Seattle Mariners. They hit 6 home runs. This team is ridiculous right now.
15 games over 500 for the first time since 2010. Now, if that gives you any perspective, last time I was in an Indians uniform. So, gosh.
Whoa, that was a while ago.
Kind of a lot's happened since then. But their 5th game with 5 or more homers. C.J. Cron on another planet right now. Byron Buxton, a grand slam. You look at the AL Central standings, they are 5.5 up. But if I'm them, you better win as many games as you can right now because you're going to come back to earth a little bit. Certainly, I think that rotation will. And the back end of their bullpen, do we still have question marks about Blake Parker closing games?
I think so.
And I think there's still some question marks, but give them credit. Yep. They have handled their business thus far.
And if you score 18 runs a game, you probably will
you
win those games. Yep. Andre Knott joins us now. Shane Bieber, he's been so good for the Indians this year and so consistent, hasn't he?
He has been completely consistent. I mean, Shane Bieber's getting ready to make his 28th career start. None of these starts. He's become one of the most consistent starters for the Indians. Most young pitchers go through ups and downs. And when talking to Carl Willis, he's been blown away that the young guy came prepared and ready early in his career.
We said it last year, Andre. I mean, similar to the discussion about Rodriguez. We saw Shane get in some situations last year and, you know, never skip a beat and pitch himself right out of them. And gosh darn, he'd only been in the league for a month or two at that point in time. And I think he's continued that. He has a very good four-pitch mix, you know, a delivery that, you know, he really owns. He commands the ball very well. And, you know, I think he's a pillar of this rotation.
You don't hear a pitching coach that's been around as long as he's been along to say something like a pillar of the rotation. He's done that. Now he's got to overcome giving up 4 home runs in his last start. He says he understands he was around the plate too much. He thinks he'll bounce back from that, guys.
I'm sure he will. Oh, my.
Yes, he will. And Shane Bieber, though, he's got to get it going because he hasn't won in a month. Not that he hasn't pitched well. Some run support, but The long ball has hurt him a little bit. That'll be the first time he's ever faced the Baltimore Orioles. So I'm sure Shane Bieber will be ready.
Oh, my. It's going to be 84 degrees at game time. It is very cloudy, and we got a strong breeze blowing. Tom Boschenik says 26 miles an hour. It's going to be blowing out toward right center field.
Ouch.
So any ball hit in the air is going to get a big boost. You talk about giving up the home run ball.
Yes.
You better keep it down today, especially to the left-handed pole hitters. Even the right-handed guys that like to go the other way can shoot one out of here today.
Yeah, that can. It's a warm, windy day, but Bieber's going to go out there and do his thing. So hopefully he keeps the ball on the ground more than he does up in the air. And Shane Bieber will be today's Northern Ohio Honda starting pitcher for the Tribe. It'll be his ninth start of the season. As I mentioned, his first ever against Baltimore. He's coming off a start against the Chicago White Sox in Chicago, where he went 6 1/3 innings, 7 hits, 5 runs. 4 of those hits were solo home runs in that ballgame. He left losing 4-2, but Bieber going to try and come back and look for his first win in his home ballpark this year.
And the starting lineup for the Baltimore Orioles under manager Brandon Hyde looks like this. Jonathan Villar in the leadoff spot. Dwight Smith will hit second. He leads the Orioles with 27 runs batted in. Trey Mancini will bat third. He's having a heck of a year. Chris Davis, Stevie Wilkerson, Renato Nunez in the middle. Rio Ruiz will hit seventh. Hanser Alberto batting eighth. And Austin Wins behind the plate today will hit ninth.
And the defense behind Shane Bieber today, they are rated fourth in the league. They've made 20 errors. In the outfield, it'll be Gonzalez. In center field, it'll be Martin, and Mercado gets the start. And right on the infield, it'll be Ramirez and Lindor on the left side. It will be Kipnis and Santana on the right side. Roberto Perez doing the catching for the Conrads defense.
Bruce Dreckman will call the balls and strikes here this afternoon. Chad Fairchild at first. Paul Emmel, the crew chief, at second base. Mike Estabrook down at third.
Orioles wearing their orange tops today for the first time in the series.
Yeah, we've had a little bit of everything. Shane Bieber goes to the hill wearing the home whites here in the series finale. Homestand, though, just getting underway. Oakland comes in tomorrow for a 3-game series, and then Tampa Bay will be here Thursday for a 4-gamer to wrap it up.
This is our 4th day being here with an off day before this, and then you get another week here. So this is our longest homestand of the year.
Take advantage of the home cooking when you can. First pitch of the day is a fastball strike to Jonathan Villar.
And that's a first. How many times we haven't seen him take many fastballs for strike one, have we?
Well, he likes that first pitch. And he takes a pair. He's in the hole 0-2.
He feels okay. It's time to be patient.
1-for-11 in the series, but that one hit was a big one. And the Orioles win. He had a 3-run homer. Just missed outside. In 12 career games against the Indians, a 130 average for Villar. He strikes out to start the game. Bieber with a good off-speed pitch goes down and in.
Yeah, breaking ball. After he goes fastball, he gets 3 fastballs. One off the plate, comes right back in with a slider down and in, and gets his first strikeout.
There is Dwight Smith Jr., and he takes the strike. It's a breaking ball.
Right. That's the breaking ball. I can see taking the breaking ball for a strike, but they haven't in the first 3 games let fastballs, many of them, go by. That's for sure.
And it's quickly 0-2 on Smith. If I read this right, there have been 28 first pitch swings and misses by the Orioles in the series. S- Swung on and missed, and Shane Bieber making quick work of the O's so far, striking out the first two.
For the Orioles, in third.
Storylines brought to you by Wayside Furniture. Trey Mancini, who is eighth in the American League in batting average and third in doubles, has hit a pair of home runs. And Shane Bieber looking for a little run support today to help out. Fouled back by Mancini.
Well, Bieber coming out of the chute. Seven of his first eight pitches are in the zone. Fine year right there by Mancini to this point.
To first, perfect hop for Santana. The Orioles go 1-2-3. The Indians are coming to bat.
...24-year-old Jeffrey Ramirez will be making the start for the Orioles, 6'2", 215. He's making his first start this year. He made one start against the Indians last August 18th right in this ballpark. He earned the loss three innings. He gave up seven runs on seven hits, five walks, while striking out two.
The Indians starting lineup for Terry Francona brought to you by Progressive Insurance. Francisco Lindor heating up. Then Jason Kipnis, he's red hot right now. Carlos Santana starting to find that stroke. Cargo, Ramirez, Bowers in the middle, Roberto Perez, Leonis Martin, and Oscar Mercado round it out. Mercado making his second straight start for the Indians here this afternoon. Smash down the right field line. And Lindor is off to the races. Mancini having a little trouble, but Frankie will pull in safely with a leadoff double.
Been very aggressive. Two pitches, and he had two good, healthy cuts right here. Here's a fastball inside. Pulls it down the line, the first baseline, into the corner. He can cruise into second base easily. That'll be Frankie's third double. So he's setting the table here in the bottom half of the first inning for the Indians.
And up comes Jason Kipnis. 4 out of 13 in the series. Bunts it off the plate. Wims grabs it, can't come up with it. Kips aboard with an infield single, and Lindor winds up at third.
Well, he was just trying to move the runner, and he ends up getting a base hit because Wins comes out behind the plate trying to get that ball before it hits the ground, because he realized once it did, he wasn't going to be able to get him. Here comes the third baseman, but it went off the plate, and once that ball hit the ground and the spin on the baseball, could not get there. Base hit for Kipnis. Good start, first and third.
Nobody out, and Carlos Santana steps in. Between May 5th and May 13th, Santana went 4-for-34 at the plate with just one run batted in. In his last four games, 5-for-13, five runs batted in. Hitters have ups and downs. You have your hot spells, you've got your slumps, cold spell, whatever you want to call it. The key is trying to curtail those stretches when you're not hot. And it looks like Santana is coming out of it. Up high, 2-0. He's been their best run producer, 25 runs batted in. Six homers, eight doubles. And the table is set for him here. Santana socks it into right field. That'll give the Indians the lead. Lindor scores, and look at Kipnis hustling all the way to third. 1-0 Cleveland. Santana's 26th run batted in on the year.
Yeah, well, that's it. When you're starting to get out of it, you're getting in situations first and third. And now watch, this is a changeup. It's almost like a split. and he leaves it upstairs, and a 2-0 count. Santana hammers it to right field. So the two balls hit on the nose and with a bunt mixed in there. And they go first and third again, and that's what you love to do. You first and third for a half an hour.
So Cargo steps in. Three on the right side of the infield for Baltimore. And a swing and a foul back. You know, last several years, the Indians have been a really good first inning team. Not so this year. They've been outscored 26-19 in the first inning coming into today. So that's their 20th run on the year in inning number one. Now Cargo drives one up the alley, deep center field. Wilkerson back on the track, leaps and makes an amazing catch. Tagging and coming home to score is Kipnis. And it's 2-0 Cleveland. It could have been a lot worse if not for an athletic play for the second time in this series by Stevie Wilkerson.
Boy, he had a long way to go to get that ball. I thought it was at least going to hit the wall, if not get out. But he drives it into right center field, and you see Wilkerson get over there and on the dead run makes the catch. Boy, that saves maybe a really big inning. That's the first out. He gets the sacrifice fly.
And the Indians lead it now 2-0.
That was a big play for Baltimore.
Here is Jose Ramirez. And Jeffrey Ramirez with a first pitch strike on the fastball.
Yeah, we were talking about that. Jeffrey Ramirez, and he spells it Y-E-F-E-Y. It's we would think Jeffrey, like we pronounce our own.
The Indians have Jeffrey Rodriguez with a J.
Yeah.
Baltimore has Jeffrey Ramirez with a Y. Why? We don't know.
Thank goodness they're not pitching against one another, because we would have a tough day, I would think.
It'd be just Ramirez and Rodriguez.
That's right.
Here's the 1-1.
That'd be the safe way to go about it.
I think you mentioned before, though, Baltimore trying to find pitching, and Ramirez making his first start of the year. Hold the string on Jose Ramirez, and the count evens at 2-2.
Yeah, has made out of the bullpen four appearances and a 5.14 ERA. So they figure they'd give him a start, but he's going to have to work hard to get through it.
Another high fastball. Jose Ramirez, that has been a problem for him from the get-go.
Let's check the Orioles defense behind Ramirez. It's going to be Smith, Wilkerson, Mancini in the outfield. On the infield, it'll be Ruiz, Villar, Alberto, and Davis, with Wins doing the catching.
Jake Bowers, the DH today.
Well, that catch out in center field by Wilkerson seemed to settle Ramirez down a little bit. He's able to come back and get Ramirez and now throw a strike here to Bowers.
You know, the amazing thing, if I remember right, I think it was Cargo that he robbed earlier in the series.
Oh, going. Yes, it was. You were right. Right over his head in center field and made a nice running catch.
Inning. Yeah.
You're right. He's taking two hits away from him. No doubt. Yeah, that was in the eighth inning. After the leadoff walk took him.
Cast AI powered by AWS. Another look at The catch.
And you can see the sprint speed over 27. That's about average. But he covered it, and he's, you know, he's played all three outfield positions. But he's made two really nice catches off the same hitter in this series.
And the other thing about that play, just, you know, watching it on the replay, as you said before, he's not a natural center fielder. I don't know how many reps he's had out there, but at the very end, almost looked like he was looking for the other outfielder coming over, like, don't run into me here.
It's all new. You know, it takes a while to get used to the guys you're playing next to, no doubt. But if you're Cargo and you're playing left field today like he is, if he hits one in your direction, don't you dare let it fall. You go take it. He's taking two from you in the series. And that's the way you approach it, too. All right, you're not going to give me one. You're not going to get one.
Two down here, opening frame for the Indians. 18th pitch of the inning for Ramirez. Runner goes, and Jake Bowers just swats it to center, but it hangs up. And Wilkerson ends up having to jump and make the catch to end the inning. Well, the inning starts with a flurry, a double, a single, another single, drives home a run. Then the defense cuts.
The MLB Ballpark app allows you to buy and manage game tickets, redeem special check-in offers, access exclusive content, and much more. Download the MLB Ballpark app today.
Second inning, and Chris Davis to lead off for Baltimore.
Well, we were talking to see if he could get Bieber some runs. The offense did just that. Put two on the board, a little crooked number for him. Maybe he can go back out there and shut him down.
Chris Davis shoots it out of play to the left. And it's 1-2. Last seven games for Davis has punched out 14 times in 25 at bats. Add another one. That's three K's now for Bieber.
Bieber looks like a man possessed today. Coming out and just pounding the strike zone and making quality pitches in turn. 11 of the first 13 pitches have been strikes, and three punch outs out of the first four hitters.
Here is Stevie Wilkerson. He hasn't just been a menace defensively with his glove, but also he's Baltimore's best hitter this month, batting 315 in May. In the series, he has four hits, including a couple of doubles and a home run. Weak ground ball gets by Bieber. Kipnis is there to grab the short hop. Two down. All right, let's take a look at our Kia. Give it everything. By division, the Indians have beat up on the AL East so far, going 6-1 against Toronto and Baltimore. But still have the Yankees and Red Sox.
Yeah, they only played just Toronto and now Baltimore.
Tampa Bay's coming in.
Well, next road trip, we'll go to Boston for our only trip there. Next Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday.
And regardless, they've got to play better in the Central. It's still early, but just a 7-10 mark in the division. That could be problematic if that continues.
Yeah, you can get on a roll there as well. But as you mentioned, they've just got to iron everything out.
Raining all of a sudden. I mean, like out of nowhere. Just
no kidding.
Started pouring.
Sort of like last year when Mercado got there yesterday. He got a base hit, and the sun was out.
Yeah.
And he ended up getting a double, but you're right. It came in the, out of nowhere. There's the skipper looking up. Might want to take those sunglasses off. May not need them.
High pop. Kip calling for it. 1-2-3 go the Birds. Middle of the second, 2-0 Cleveland.
Well, Oakland makes its only trip to town for a three-game set beginning tomorrow night. We've got a 6 o'clock Monday, 6 o'clock Tuesday, 1 o'clock on getaway day. You can pick up a $15 district ticket presented by Miller Lite or a $15 KeyBank Kids ticket. Come on down to the ballpark. Visit Indians.com for your tickets.
Bottom of the second inning, and Roberto Perez will lead off for the Indians. Just a few stray raindrops falling. The 1-0. And Roberto grounds one between third and short, and it's in the left field. Leadoff man aboard for the second inning in a row.
Well, they want this ball down and away. He didn't quite get it away enough. But he got his ground ball, but it finds the hole between short and third as Perez will get a hit in his first at bat. That's number four already for the Indians.
Seven times in this series, an Indians leadoff man has reached on a hit, once via a walk, once hit by a pitch, and that has all led to six runs so far. Leonis Martin, a can of corn to center field, 1-0. Let's go down to Andre Knott, who has the story on Oscar Mercado's first major league hit.
Well, Oscar Mercado had that first major league hit yesterday. You saw right there, that was a double for his first hit. Family was here from Tampa. They were able to take the ball home yesterday. But I thought the fun part of this was that was not his bat he was using. That was a bat from the one and only Jose Ramirez. Jose took care of him when he got here, picked up the bat. He said he liked it. So Jose has ordered more for him. And he says between Jose and Cargo, those two guys have been very big for him his first week in the major leagues and just helping him prepare, get ready, and even give him some bats.
Very nice. It's always good to see the veterans take the young guy under the wing.
And he's got to feel, you know, you get that first hit out of the way, you always feel much better about yourself. Well, he needs another one, Jose. Can you get one? It's off the end. Jose said, get him another one. You see the cupped end. When you hit it off that, you see the splinter he's carrying back. Well, this one's a little different color, so. Watch, right off the cupped end of this thing. There it is. That's missing about 2 ounces right there.
Upstairs with that fastball, 2-1. Plate, three balls in the strike. Baltimore first year manager Brandon Hyde. This guy never changes his expression. 3-1. Popped him straight up. This is playable between home and third. Ruiz calling for it, and there are two down. Brandon Hyde is not a guy you'd ever want to have to play poker against.
Yeah.
He looks the same all the time.
Well, maybe that's why he wears those shades, so you can't see his eyes and which way he's looking.
It could be. And, you know, they, hey, look, they're going to have moments this year.
Yeah.
It's a rebuild.
It's not an easy job. You're right.
He's already seen some things this year that he probably thought, I didn't think we had to cover that, but all right, let's bring it in here.
You never realize it until you become a manager.
Francisco Lindor ripped a base hit down the right field line. It was just inside the bag at first and went for a double. That sparked a two-run rally in the first for Cleveland. Davis holding Roberto Perez on at first is right in the path of where that first ball Frankie hit went. Though as hard as he hit that ball in the first inning, he hits another one down there like Davis. It's going to be tough to grab it just because he is really close to home plate now.
Yeah, he's about 85 feet away.
And there's another one. Smoke fair down the right field line again. Berto in the third. Sarbaugh's going to hold him there. It'll be another double for Lindor.
Another multi-hit game for Frankie. Number 10, both extra base hits. And, you know, with Perez on first, you're almost going to have to hit one out to score him. But it gets down into the corner, and Mancini gets it into Alberto, and you have to hold him up. That's his best, man. He's trying. But held up, and he has to go back. Sarbaugh, you can see, hold up, hold up. So a chance now with two outs for Kipnis. And he's been one of the better ones with two outs, driving in the runs.
Six out of 13 this year with runners in scoring position and two out for Jason Kipnis. It's been a real bedrock for this Indians offense.
Got a base hit on a bunt the first time up, moving Lindor from second to third after he led off the inning with a hit. Now he's trying to drive in a pair.
He's reached in 14 straight games. Kipnis now has hit in five straight games, seven out of his last 19 overall. Light rain continuing to fall, even though the sun is darting in and out of the clouds. 1-1. Fastball just above the strike zone. Jeffrey Ramirez trying to work out of a jam here in the second with two out. Now he's ready with the 1-2 pitch. Another one well out of the zone, 2-2.
Well, that one he didn't really have a chance to swing at. Well, let's see if he follows it up with that that split change he has.
Down low, gets away from Austin Wins. Roberto Perez will score from third. Lindor goes to third, 3-0 Cleveland.
Well, that didn't look like that bad of a pitch. Did that hit the dirt? Let's go take a look at this. Does it get into the dirt? He's putting his glove there. I don't know. That wasn't that bad of a pitch. He was late getting down there. It's a pass ball. And I think it should be, because that ball should have been caught, if not blocked. It didn't look like it hit the dirt. He was just pointing to his pitcher. It's my fault, but cost him a run on the pass ball.
And still a runner at third with two down and a 3-2 count now for Kipnis. Broke his bat and we'll get another chance with a new piece of lumber.
That is the eighth pass ball for Baltimore catching this year.
Yeah, between the wild pitches and the pass balls, it's not been pretty.
Yeah, the eighth, and that leads the league by plenty. Normally you see a lot of pass balls, you have a knuckleballer on the staff, but that's not the case.
Do they also lead the league in wild pitches as well?
I think they do, yes.
So again, that's just... a lot of extra opportunities.
Yeah, they have that 27. Yes, they do. The wind's starting to pick up a little bit, too, when you look high atop the scoreboard. It is whipping. There you go. Good look at it right there.
26 miles an hour at game time. And it may have picked up from there. Again, the 3-2. And another foul ball. Been a long inning for Jeffrey Rod Ramirez. Ninth pitch of the at bat here for Jason Kipnis. And Ramirez strikes him out to end the inning, but the Indians tack one on. They lead it now 3-0 after two.
Be here for the Sugardale Dollar Dog Night on Friday when the Tampa Bay Rays come to town. You can head to the game early for a pregame block party out in the district. That is presented by Coors Light. And stay after the game for fireworks. Get your tickets at Indians.com.
Rio Ruiz will lead off for Baltimore here in the third inning. And Shane Bieber misses down low, ball one. Bieber been a strike-throwing machine here at the outset. ...15 out of his first 20 pitches were strikes. And now he misses on the first two to Ruiz, who does lead Baltimore this year with 18 walks.
Good swing.
And the Orioles have their first hit.
Well, you get a 2-0 count, and you look for that fastball, you get it, and he put a good swing on it, taking it the other way.
Injury report brought to you by the attorneys at Elk and Elk. And for the Indians, we know Corey Kluber is just in a waiting mode with the fracture in the forearm. Tyler Naquin has the calf injury. Bradley Zimmer, Mike Clevenger. Clevenger's getting closer and closer to working his way back. And there's also some good news, I understand, on Danny Salazar. We'll get an update here from Andre right after this pitch to Hanser Alberto. Drake.
All right, here we go. Clev will go back out. He threw 35 pitches, fastballs and changeups yesterday. He will be back out probably Tuesday to throw more. He's going to throw three or four more pins. Then they will send him out, Rick. So they hope June 7th he'll be good to go.
Good.
Also, on Salazar, he's bounced back pretty well. He's actually throwing out in Arizona. And Zimmer this weekend has been DHing in Arizona. He's getting closer to possibly going to Columbus or somewhere to start a rehab. So he's finally getting close. Salazar has made some steps after he had his arm checked out again just a few weeks
ago. Is he throwing off a mound yet?
Well, it's not.
Or is he on dry ground or flat ground?
Yeah, it's flat ground and throwing from 120, 150. Hopefully they'll get him on the mound by the end of this next week is what the hope is.
Thanks, yeah. Andre. Hanser Alberto, two for his last 24 against right-handed pitching. Ooh, what was wrong with that? Wow.
Nothing. You could see him saying, my goodness. He doesn't like that. That's definitely a strike. All day long. That's a perfect pitch.
Santana will step on the bag. He'll throw down to second in a double play.
Well, Santana did a really good thing right there. He almost looked like he didn't have the ball cleanly, but he took his time and made sure he had the grip on it. As he stepped on first base, he knew he had time to throw to second and really does a nice play. Watch. He doesn't have that ball cleanly. Get it in that glove. Let me get a good grip on it, and they get it easily. So a nice double play.
Two gone for Austin Wins. Baltimore catcher hasn't played much this year, but he stepped in the other night, got a start, had two hits and a walk, scored a run. Elevated the fastball and able to pump it by him.
Should get a fastball in this count. 3-1. He did.
Second hit of the inning.
So the 2-0 count, fastball, and he's not going to walk anybody. He's going to come at you and he's going to make you put the ball in play, and they do. So their second hit of the inning, but that double play ball, he had a chance of getting out here just facing the minimum after three. Still only at 32 pitches here in the top half of the third.
Well, Jonathan Villar struck out in the first inning.
Look at 7-8-9 hitting the best off of Bieber. That's interesting. Well, he's going to probably be a little, I think he's aggressive to everybody, but. Maybe if he does fall behind any hitters down at 7-8-9, you know what you're going to get is a fastball.
Santana can't corral that one. And it will send Austin Wins all the way to third. VR will hold with a two-out single. Third hit of the inning for Baltimore, though. That one,
it was hit hard, but I think he can make the play. I think he's got to catch that ball. Because it was hit hard, no doubt. He's coming off first. He's ready. He's in position. But it was hit hard. It's right there. Glove side. Didn't really have to reach for it too much. I think he should have made the play. But I think do they give him a hit? Yes. So they keep it going.
And Dwight Smith Jr., who saw three pitches his first time up. Curveball, a changeup, and a slider. That's a guy who loves the fastball. Got his fastball there, but it fouled it back. He's been a monster for Baltimore with runners in scoring position, batting 412. And five of his eight home runs have come when there have been runners in scoring position.
Yeah, well, he's the man leading with the RBI. This is one guy you want to be careful with. Nice breaking ball. So now he has him down in the count 0-2. Nice slider down and in. He knows he's a fastball hitter. He started him off breaking ball first pitch, but he just did tip that glove, but right into the glove of Perez.
Here now the 0-2. Struck him out looking with a fastball. Fourth K for Shane Bieber. Orioles get three hits, leave two stranded. Middle of the third, 3-0 Indians. Just a reminder, if you're enjoying a cold one, stay tuned later in the game for our Miller Lite Hold True moment. Bottom of the third, it will be the third hitter in the lineup, Carlos Santana, to lead off. RBI single his first time up. Santana, six hits in his last 14 at bats, with six runs batted in now in the last five games.
Yeah, the 2-0 pitch that he smoked to right field his last at bat. It was a change that was upstairs.
Santana rocks one to deep right field and is gone to Souvenir City. Seventh home run of the year for Santana, and it's 4-0 Cleveland.
Well, Carlos gets his seventh. He hit the changeup his first at bat, and he gets a heater here. Check it out. Right there, challenged him, but boy, he smoked it. That's right in his wheelhouse. So with a pair of RBIs today, he makes it a 4-0 game.
Now Carlos Gonzalez.
Don't hit it to center.
Santana back on a hot streak now. Six out of 11 in the series.
Yeah, isn't it something? The right side got him going.
Yeah.
You know, because in this series, he had his first three hits from the right side of the plate. Boy, then he flipped over yesterday and something started to kick in, and now he's swinging it from both sides.
Just a little high, 3-1. Just did catch the outside corner. That'll run the count full.
And of the six hits that the Indians have, five of them have been pulled. Both of Lindor's, Both the Santanas and Perez. Kipnis had the bunt trying to move the runner.
There's ball four. And the Indians have a base runner for Jose Ramirez. Stat of the game brought to you by Buick. Indians have hit 22 go-ahead home runs on the year. That's fourth best in the league. Not to mention a couple that have ended games.
Yeah, and Carlos had one.
Jose Ramirez takes a pitch just a bit low. Jose just three for his last 27 at the plate. Jeffrey Ramirez allowed two runs in the first, one in the second, now one here in the third. And the Indians looking for more. They had a chance for a bigger inning in the first, if not for the great catch by Wilkerson.
Yeah, it really settled Ramirez down after that catch there to get out of that inning. And then last inning, they were able to, score on a pass ball. And then Santana leads up this inning with a solo homer.
Another high fastball. My goodness, he just.
Well, and it's,
there is no stopping him from swinging at that pitch this year.
It is, there isn't. And a lot of times, that's what he's ahead in the count, like he is here, a 2-1 pitch, but that's out of the strike zone, and he's been chasing that all year long. You're right.
Bounced one way out in front of the plate, and a nice block by Austin Wins.
Send along some birthday wishes. Ruth Grady of Parma is turning 97 today. Alex Del Benet of Girard is 91. And Mary Black of Euclid is 89. Happy birthday to you all.
Three-two pitch down low, ball four. So Jose ends up drawing a walk. Back-to-back walks now in the inning for Ramirez.
That's got to be of some concern for Brandon Hyde and company.
Yeah, you certainly don't want to give any extra base runners up.
Let's go back and take a look at the Santana home run again on StatCast.
Yeah, that was a ball right into his wheelhouse, elevated a little bit. Oh, the line drive, so it only took a little over 4 seconds to get out of there. Santana with the team lead and homers now with seven.
Well, Jake Bowers is at the plate. Conference at the mound breaks up. Jake has 9 hits in 31 at-bats with runners in scoring position. Seems like, Arch, when he gets into these situations, when you get runners in scoring position, that he'll use more of the whole field. I don't know if it's a concerted effort or
concentration
what happened.
Level, like he wants to get that run home.
Seen him go to left center quite a few times in these.
Matter of fact, in game one, he had a, drove in the only run in that one game that we
That's
lost.
Right.
He went to left center field and put a really good swing on it.
Down low, 2-0.
Yeah, he's right now. I don't know if he's nibbling or what, but it's tough to pitch from behind, especially when you're already down by four. But these guys can get a little more selective, get themselves in. They don't have to swing at his good pitch if he makes one.
Bowers trying to go the other way, but this is a lazy pop to left, and Dwight Smith will make the grab, and the runners have to hold. One down. That That's going to bring up Roberto Perez. And Roberto had a base hit between third and short his first time up. He's another guy that's been swinging the bat much better. Last 15 games coming in, a 292 average with three homers and seven runs batted in. So Roberto has, I don't know if he's found something or if he's just feeling better at the plate, more opportunities this year.
Well, it certainly
helps. Because he started off slow.
Yeah. And it helps, though, when you're playing every day and you get in that batter's box. You really got a better idea of the strike zone and what you want to do.
Yes, that's exactly what he said last week in Oakland. He says more at bat, seeing more pitches. And as we always hear from these guys, a better routine. And he said, I asked, is it because he's playing every day the routine's better? And he kind of shrugged his shoulders and he said he hadn't thought of that, but he thinks just seeing more pitches is helping.
And you know what, though? He's not an aggressive hitter to begin with.
Right.
He's a guy that takes a lot of pitches. And, you know, a lot of times if you get in there and you're out there every day, sometimes he'll get up. Let's go after that first pitch because, you know, he doesn't swing at a lot of first pitch strikes. He gets counts in his favor and he doesn't swing at a lot. And going against this guy in this inning now, it's great. He's only thrown six strikes and 13 balls. So this guy is, you know, you're going to get yourself in a hitter's count.
I think this will be ruled a wild pitch, but this is another one that was.
Yeah, that would be a wild pitch. But you're right. It was lazy getting the backhand out there. You got to get a.
Especially when you've got runners on base and in scoring position.
You've got to put a body on it and stop them from advancing. Now they got to bring the infield in, advantage Cleveland, and you're already down four runs. You can't afford to give up anything else, so you have to block that ball and keep it in front.
And Roberto tries to go up the middle. It's cut off, but the run will score. Cargo comes home. Roberto gets the RBI. It's his 13th on the year, and it's now 5-0 Cleveland.
And there you go. There's the difference right there because Cargo's going on contact. Even though the ball was hit, you see, at second you freeze. He didn't have time to get up and throw it because he had to go to the ground. He scores easily, so that's an easy RBI for Perez. Because a ball was not blocked and kept those runners at first and second. So that's a gift run.
And with two down, Leonis Martin to the plate.
You know, it's little things in the game of baseball that add up over the course of a year. And those are things you have to do consistently as a team if you want to stay in a lot of ball games.
Martin, pull hitter. They've got the shift on with that in mind, especially balls that are hit on the ground. Does have a hit in six of his last seven games.
This guy started out 5 of 6 first pitch strikes this game today. And since that point, 1 of 11. So they have been behind. He's been behind in the count.
Popped up this. Should get out of play, and it will. Well, you know, you look at Ramirez on the mound and you think, well, 5 out of 6 first pitch strikes. Well, that didn't work out real well. They had 3 hits and 2 runs.
Right.
So he tried the other way. That hasn't worked out either, pitching from behind. So.
Yeah, but as a starter, and if you're coming out of that bullpen, you know you have to throw strikes, even if they're getting base hits. The manager would rather have you hit out of the ball game than walk yourself out of the ball game.
Gets his third strikeout to end the inning. But the Indians keep adding to the lead. Carlos Santana goes yard. It's 5-0 Indians. 5-0, Indians on top, fourth inning. Shane Bieber will face Trey Mancini. Then Chris Davis and Stevie Wilkerson. Swung out and missed.
Mancini hit a nice one hopper to Carlos at first base, who's playing in the hole. His first at bat had an easy unassisted play.
Fastball right there, and Mancini obviously looking for something else. Watch the express go by. 5 Ks for Bieber.
Well, that's the second straight guy that's taken a fastball with two strikes. And I mean, that was right there, 95 miles an hour, but he didn't pull the trigger. They must be sitting on that slider from Bieber, but he could throw that fastball right by you. Bieber today, 6-0-2, 1-2 counts.
Chris Davis called out on strikes in the second inning. Two and two. Missed off the plate. Strike three called, another 95 mile an hour fastball right down Ontario Street, and Davis just watched it sail by.
Three straight called strikeouts on fastballs with two strikes. It's mind-boggling. Usually you'll maybe think about looking at something like that, but they might have a different scouting report. I don't know, but that's strikeout number six for Shane Bieber.
Filling up the strike zone. Stevie Wilkerson grounded out his only time up. Takes a fastball, just missed. 1-1. Got in on him, popped him up. Cargo rolling in hard from left field. He'll make the catch.
Yeah, take him away. Take that head away from him.
The Orioles go 1-2-3. Shane Bieber has struck out 6 and 4 shutout innings of work. Get your all-star experience at Play Ball Park, coming to the Huntington Convention Center in the downtown malls July 5th through the 9th. Meet the stars of the game, train like the pros, work on your pitching skills and more. Information available online at allstargame.com. Oscar Mercado takes a strike from Jeffrey Ramirez. Mercado fouled out his only time up. up and away. 2-2. And that's in the dirt, full count. Lindor waiting on deck. There you go. He did not go, and it's a leadoff walk. Four innings. The Indians have had their leadoff man aboard all four times. Our Scots triple threat, the St. Louis Cardinals, the Brooklyn Dodgers, and now the Houston Astros, the only teams to have two different 10-game winning streaks before the calendar turned to June.
Yeah, that's amazing. That Houston team's on a roll.
There goes Mercado, shot out of a cannon. Throw down. Don't even bother.
Yeah, you're right.
Oh, they're going to say he came off the base because he clearly beat the throw in the tag. And Paul Hamill says he's out, I'm assuming because at some point during the slide, he came off the base.
Well, he had it stolen easy. I mean, you know, and then... we'll look at his feet. If it stays on his left foot, does he go on? I mean, it was no question he was safe. He stole it. There he is. Plenty of time. But now, does he overslide the bag?
VR.
Oh, he's got the foot over again. He's blocking the bag.
But was he off the base?
Now look at his hand. Does his left hand stay on the base? There it is. There it is. There it is. No, it came off.
Right
off and he, hey, that's right. That's a good call. I hate it, but it's a good call. When you slow it down frame by frame like that, he had it easily. But in this series, we see somebody go in hand first. We saw he was blocking the bag at that point, too.
Got to go in there with your spikes.
Yes, you do. Go right at him, and he'll get it out of there.
Well, that's a shame. One down.
There you go. You see the tag's still on him, and his backhand is just a hair, it looks like, off the bag. But the front foot, his left foot couldn't get there because VR's was blocking it. I mean, that's fine. That's legal. And another walk. That's now number four.
And they've all come in the last two innings.
Yes.
Doug Brocale, the pitching coach, going to take a slow walk to the mound. Oh, that's the manager. I'm sorry. That's Brandon Hyde. He's done.
Yeah, he's seen enough.
Seen enough. So that was a quick warm-up. And Richard Blyer will be coming on when we come back. Cleveland Clinic call to the bullpen has been made. Jeffrey Ramirez goes 3 1/3 innings here this afternoon, allowing 5 runs. But the 4 walks over the last 2 frames hasten his exit here today. Five nothing Indians shutting out the Orioles here this afternoon. Tribe has one on, one out, and we'll go down to Andre Knott.
Well, you guys mentioned the Houston Astros having those two 10-game win streaks, and we all know the Michael Brantley effect and how Francisco Lindor still adores everything that he learned from him. Well, when you talk to the Houston people, they say one of the things that he's been able to accomplish is help George Springer, and I don't want to go all Big Al on us, become an MVP candidate. Right now he's leading in home runs and RBI, and basically, he told George Springer from the very beginning, we hit in the cages out before the game. If you guys remember, George Springer and a lot of the Astros players would only hit in the cage underneath before games, wouldn't come out. Michael was taking him under his wing, and he's made him come out hitting not only back in the cages but out in the field. And George Springer has basically said his career has changed because of what Michael Brantley has brought to the table.
Yeah, he calls him Uncle Mike, too.
Yes.
He calls him Uncle Mike. But when you sprinkle in a left-hander and the quality of Brantley, a great two-strike hitter. They see his approach. He's patient. And they're basically a right-handed hitting team. man, that rubs off on them. And when you put in a good a hitter as Brantley is in that lineup, it just makes them that much better.
You want to know how good Brantley's going, boys? It's early in Boston in the game that they're playing. They made a big deal that he struck out in the first inning against Chris Sale because he hasn't struck out that much.
Yeah,
this year.
Well, that's what I'm saying. A great two-strike hitter. He puts it in play. He's patient. And he's in a hitter-friendly ballpark, so the homers are up, ribbies are up. He's having a great year. Not to our surprise.
Jason Kipnis, a bunt single and a run scored. That came in the first, struck out in the second. Richard Blyer trying to keep the Orioles' hopes alive here. They're down five runs. Ouch.
Yeah, Blyer came out in the first game of this series against the Tribe, went an inning and two-thirds, gave up two hits, a couple of runs, had two walks, and one strikeout. Right off the foot, front foot. Let's see, does he get the pad? No, just that's almost like that thing lifted up and got underneath it.
Bouncer and a nice block by Wins. Kipnis pops one up. It's caught in left field by Dwight Smith. Two down. Spectrum Mobile Replay. Start of the game. Francisco Lindor led it off with a double. And Jason Kipnis, the bunt single off the plate. Carlos Santana brought home the first run with a line drive, vicious line drive. And then Cargo almost blew the doors open.
Yeah, no kidding. That play really kept it in check and settled that inning down. And that was it. They were only able to get two, but they added one in the second, two in the third, and they're trying to do some more damage here with two outs now. Or excuse me. Yeah, two outs. That's right. They're caught stealing after the back-to-back walks.
Runner goes. Ball gets away. Another one. Yet another wild pitch. But I guess he was running, so they gave him stolen base.
Yeah, they'll give him a stolen base. He was off and running in no time. They're not expecting him to go.
That would have been another wild pitch.
Right, that saved him the wild pitch. He gets a stolen base because he was running.
Santana with a bouncer to short. VR makes a good throw to get him, and the inning is over. Four complete, Indians five, Orioles nothing. Cleveland Indians baseball is brought to you by the all-new 2020 Kia Telluride. Give it everything. By Meijer, proud sponsor of local sports throughout Ohio. Because when we support the home team, we all win. And by your Chevy Network dealers. Visit clickchevy.com. Chevrolet, find new roads. Another beautiful day here at the ballpark. Game time temperature today, 84 degrees. Had a few sprinkles a couple of innings ago, but man, it has been spectacular. Renato Nunez to lead off for Baltimore, and another first pitch strike from Shane Bieber. He has struck out six. All six strikeouts have come among the top four hitters in the lineup.
Four of those six have been called.
back.
We've had a number of balls come back our way this series. Normally, it's tough to get this angle. We've got a few close.
Two-two. Oh, everybody thought it was strike three. Bieber was moving. I think the hitter thought it was.
You know, he started that walk towards first base or off the side of the mound, and it was not called, so we'll see.
Swung on and missed. He got him to go fish anyway. Seven strikeouts for Bieber, one gone here in the fifth. Time for a Ganley Subaru game break. Here's Al Pawlowski.
All right, Matt and Rick, the ball is flying out of the park in New York. Tampa Bay and the Yankees. Three-run homer here, top of the third inning. Brandon Lau, number 10 on the year for Lau. That makes it 5-3 already. They move to the bottom of the fourth inning. Still 5-3, the Rays leading the Yankees in a very interesting series, fellas.
Yeah, they've been going at it. Trading places in first place.
Oakland's up in Detroit. They come in here next, and then Tampa Bay will follow.
Yes,
tried to hold up, but he went around. It's 0-2. Swings and pops it up. And Martin calls everybody off. Two down. Hanser Alberto bounced into a double play his first time up.
The 23rd double play. This is going to be, oh yeah, fair ball.
Just the third hit for Alberto in his last 26 at bats against a right-handed pitcher. So with two down, he's aboard for Austin Wins, who's done nothing but hit in this series. See what the difference is this time around. First time up, he was in a 3-1 count. He was able to just kind of zero in, and he just waited back, took a ball and lined it over the head of Jason Kipnis for a single. Now he's down on the count 0-2. Low and away, he's able to lay off. swung out and missed. He struck him out, and that's 8 Ks for Shane Bieber. 5 shutout innings of work for the right-hander. Halfway through, 5-0 Cleveland. Join the Velasano Tribe Ride, a family fun bike ride that rolls right through Progressive Field. All the money raised supports life-saving cancer research at Cleveland Clinic. 100% unforgettable fun, and it's all for the cure. Visit Velasano.org today. Carlos Gonzalez will lead off the bottom of the fifth for the Indians. Picked up an RBI in the first inning. Scored a run in the third.
Well, the first four innings, their leadoff men have been aboard every time. Double, single, homer, walk.
And if you go back to yesterday, the last time they batted, Carlos Santana led off the inning with a home run.
Okay, then there we have it, two homers. So the last five innings.
Two and two. Two pitch and a ground ball foul. Away. So Cargo having himself a good at bat here. Twice in this series, Carlos Gonzalez has been robbed of extra bases by center fielder Stevie Wilkerson. Happened again today in the first inning.
Yeah, he keeps falling them off, staying alive.
Swing and a miss. He gets the strikeout, one down. This was the first time Wilkerson robbed Cargo of a hit. That was in a key spot Friday night when the Indians were trying to rally from behind. That really thwarted what would have been a big rally maybe. And then here today in the first inning, he went into the gap, leaped and hung on.
Yeah, that glove went back and had to go behind him. He was around the start of the warning track. But still two good catches.
Jose Ramirez has struck out and walked today. Pulls that foul. And there's a fly ball to right field. Routine play for Trey Mancini. two gone. Mid-game recap brought to you by your local Toyota dealers. Carlos Santana gave the Indians a 1-0 lead with an RBI single in the first. He homered again in the third inning. Second home run of the series for Santana. And the Indians lead it 5-0 now here in the fifth. Jake Bauer's 0 for 2, his fly to center, fly to left. Swings and fouls the first pitch back. Third baseman Ruiz throws him out. 1-2-3 go the Indians for the first time today. They lead it 5-0. Our great clip of the game from yesterday, Adam Pletko, what a job he did. Went out 6 innings of shutout baseball, gave up 1 hit. He had 18 outs, 6 on the ground, 8 in the air, 4 via the strikeout. The key for Pletko yesterday, 13 out of the 20 batters that he faced, he had 2 strikes on. So he had them kind of on their heels all day long and just did a fantastic job.
Yes, he certainly did.
Aggressive in the strike zone is what he said he was mainly trying to do, and he said he just worked off the catcher and everything went great.
First ball swinging, Jonathan Villar grounds one to Lindor, and Francisco throws him out, one away.
Matt, Rick, I know that we've had a conversation, I don't know if on the air, but we've talked about the baseballs and what they're using down in AAA this year. They're using the major league ball.
Right.
So last night when we were going through the game, I kind of asked Shane Bieber about that, and he looked at me and laughed. He said his first start last year in Minnesota was the first time he had ever touched a major league baseball. He said it was so different. It took him 2-3 innings to be able to feel how he could throw it and when he could throw it. And he says the ball just moves differently, and he feels bad for the minor league pitchers now, but he says it's a good thing because he keeps up with a lot of the younger guys that he's kind of come up with. And he says it's amazing talking to guys in a triple A that are finally using the ball that's used up here. He says, yes, it's going out of the park. He goes, but he thinks it helps these guys for when they get here.
I would agree, yeah. I mean, why wouldn't they use the same baseball everywhere throughout the minor leagues? I don't care if it's
well,
eight ball.
Yeah, why haven't they? It's obviously there's a difference.
I mean, I can't answer that question, but I think it's ridiculous. Everybody should be using the same thing.
Well, and we won't say names, but even Shane said, he goes, if you're a guy in single A or double A, and you think there's a real chance you can make it to the majors, you may want to get him to triple A sooner than later so he can see what that ball is like.
Right.
0-2 pitch to Dwight Smith, down and in.
But Matt, he said just throwing sliders and curveballs so different from when last year with the triple A ball.
Because the seams aren't as high, right?
Right.
They're a little lower on the baseball. They're trying to get a good feel for it.
They're lower and tighter is what he basically said.
Well, that's probably why guys have to use pine tar sometimes so they can get a feel for it.
The 1-2. Missed in off the plate. Well, I mean, it is. That just sounds like too much common sense.
What, to use the same ball all the way through?
Sometimes those are the things that you really stupefy you. Like, you're what? What do you mean you don't have the same reason?
Well, they're made in two different countries. You know, I mean, the minor league balls were, and then the major league. So it's hard to understand why everybody doesn't use the same. Why are they saving money because of the baseballs?
Great question. I don't know. 3-2. Swung on and missed. And that is 9 strikeouts for Shane Bieber. And there are 2 down here in the 6th inning.
Well, you look at Shane Bieber, and I mean, he made him swing at that pitch, and he's got a Smith 3 times. But when you look at the slider, that is his money pitch, man. That's he doesn't give up many hits on that, and they just keep going over it. And when you continue to throw strikes with your fastball, you get to 2 strikes. They know you're a strike thrower. And then he throws that slider. They swing and miss. And he had 3 consecutive called third strikeouts coming to end the third and the first 2 in the fourth where they took the fastball because they must have been looking for that slider. First time through the lineup where they had two hits. He threw 32 pitches. Second time they had two hits. He threw 36 pitches. And now working his way through for the third time. And his pitch count now, as you can see, is at 77 pitches. And 0-2 and two outs.
Down the line on the 1-2 pitch. Yes. Did he go? Yes. He did. He strikes him out. That's 10 strikeouts for Shane Bieber, who is taking another huge step forward and establishing himself as one of the real pillars of this Indian starting rotation. Shane Bieber having himself quite an afternoon. Offensively, the Indians scoring two in the first, one in the second, two more in the third. Richard Blyer has come on and at least restored some order from Baltimore's side of things. Roberto Perez leading off, takes a strike. I don't think of Richard Blyer as a long man, so I'm not sure how much longer they plan to go with it.
True, they do have somebody up in the bullpen, but you're right, they got to get innings and outs. Sometimes you may have to be extended.
Yeah,
you just never know. I mean, this is a four game series, and the way it started out when the Indians had that 14-run, 14-hit game, and you're thinking, oh my goodness, boy, they've got a long way to go with three games left in this series. But they came right back, and Dylan Bundy ended up pitching very well the second game and beating the Indians.
Roberto Perez pulls that foul. Count stays 1-2. To third, backhanded nicely by Ruiz, and a low throw but picked out by Davis for out number one. T-Mobile connection to the game. Mike Trout hit his 250th career home run last night, and the Angels win over Kansas City. Sixth player in American League history to get to 250 before the age of 28.
The names on that board.
I have a feeling we're going to be seeing his name connected to those same names for
forever.
Quite a while.
Yeah, forever. No doubt.
Knock on wood, he stays healthy. All those things have to happen. Leonis Marti rips one down the right field line, and he can run all day. He's got at least two. And he will hold right there with a one-out double.
Third double of the afternoon for the Indians. It's a one-out double. And he just pulls this ball, that ball, middle of the plate, that breaking ball, and speeds up his bat. It got it by Davis at first base. And once it gets down to that corner, they're not playing them to pull down that far. But just a double. And I think that's going to do it for Blyer.
That's the answer to our question.
Yeah.
Richard Blyer goes two innings of relief, and we'll leave with one on, one out here in the sixth, and the Indians leading the Orioles 5-0.
Well, on Saturday, 15,000 fans are going to receive a bobblehead of Francisco Lindor. That's commemorating his Puerto Rico game. The home run, that'll be courtesy of Sugardale. You get to the game early, enjoy pregame in the district. Go to theindians.com, or you can use the ballpark app for your tickets.
One on, one out. Oscar Mercado, the batter. Gabriel Ynoa, the new pitcher for the Birds. Mercado fouled out on the second, walked in the fourth. Shoots that one over toward the Baltimore dugout.
Ynoa pitched in the first game of this series, too, on Thursday. Went an inning and two-thirds, gave up four hits and four runs. Walked one and struck out three.
Hit left field. Mercado will drive home Martin. He's on his way to second base, and he's got himself an RBI double. It's 6-0 Cleveland. Oscar Mercado with his first run batted in now in the big leagues.
Hey, his second double, and this is coming on a breaking ball that stayed up a little bit for him as he drives it down to left field. Gets to the wall, so back-to-back doubles from Martin, and now Mercado making a 6-0 ball game.
And up comes Francisco Lindor, who has two hits today, both of them doubles, and has walked and stolen a base as well. Got himself a slow breaking ball. And he almost came out of his shoes trying to hit that one. I think he's having a little meeting with himself saying, okay.
Yeah, turn it down a little bit. Yeah, he wanted to hit it a long way.
The thing you notice about Mercado when he runs, especially, you know, home to second like that, the speed is one thing, but it's those long strides. I mean, he just covers a lot of ground.
Stolen base attempt where he was safe before he slides off the bag. He had a tremendous jump. That's some speed in the lineup when he's in there. Thing of it is, it seems like we have just too many outfielders. You know, everybody. Luplo's been hot. He's hit what, five homers in the last 10 games. I thought he'd be in there today. He's not. You know, you got to take a look at some of these guys over the course of a extended period of time. The platoon system for a lot of young guys doesn't really work that well.
Jordan Luplo in the middle of your screen.
Yeah, hit a homer yesterday. Just missed one the other night. So you figure, man, he's going to be in there. But he wasn't today. Mercado gets the start, but he's been on twice.
Well, Arch, Tito has admitted this is he doesn't want to say a problem, but it's something that he's working through. He says he wants to see more Luplo. He wants to see Mercado. He goes, but then you have three left-handed swinging outfielders.
Yeah.
And it's hard to make a lineup when a right-handed starting pitcher is on the mound. And you got lefties sitting over beside you.
Well, that's true, but you have to take a look at the righties at some point in time,
right,
too, even against right-handers. Right? I mean, we don't have right-handed hitters. That's our problem.
He has said for the last week he wants to see Luplo as much as he possibly can. He says he's almost proven that he can hit triple-A hitting. He hit over 300 there, you know, in his career in Pittsburgh.
Right.
He hit 350 when he went back this last time. He wants to give him an opportunity, but then you got a guy like Mercado's up here. Heck, we've been talking about this in spring training.
I know.
You've said something to him in spring training about this.
Exactly. Too many outfielders. You got to make a selection to pick him. But, you know, some of the young guys that come over, they're going to have to play.
Attaboy, Glenn.
Oh, he's right
Glenn,
on.
Glenn doesn't like his new spot, boys.
Where is he? Right behind home plate?
He's right behind
home plate. No, because we got him caged in. He's like an animal.
He's a caged animal, yes. He said, it's not as many people to talk
he
to.
He likes to rove down the right field line.
He's a caged bear.
Part of it. He's a cage.
Missed outside.
Can't deliver his pizzas from behind that.
They have to get him to bring a pizza now that he's got nothing to do back there.
He's been eating them all.
We've just made his, it looks like it. We just made his weekend, by the way.
Come on, Ditka.
The Ditka game.
He doesn't have his MLB app on.
Here's the 1-2 on its way to Lindor, and he took it off the ground. He knows he's going to throw to third, threw it away. Mercado will score, and speed has created yet another run for the Indians here in the sixth.
Yes, it did. He had him. He really did have him. And then all of a sudden, I don't know if he rushed the throw. I got to take a look at it again. I wasn't sure if it was wide or it surprised Ruiz at third. But Lindor just trying to put it in play. And he's on the side. Yeah, it's just a bad throw from the pitcher. He threw it wide. He had him. He realized it. And then he bends over and says, oh, my goodness. And he was on the side of the mound. So I don't know if that had anything to do with it. But he had to rush it. And there you go. You come up and you score. So probably fielder's choice error on the throw, I would think.
Jason Kipnis, the batter. What we've seen for the most part in this series is exactly what Terry Francona told me on the eve of the series, which was, the thing about Baltimore is you want to take advantage of their aggressiveness, force them into mistakes, not have it happen the other way around. And for the most part, I think that's kind of what we've seen play out here.
It is in this series. I totally agree with you. The only time they couldn't do it is when they only had a couple of hits.
Yeah.
And you didn't have base runners to do anything. They were shut down after scoring 14 runs on Friday night. But other than that, they've been able to, you know, apply a little pressure to Baltimore's defense. And it has worked out that way. Case in point, that last play right there.
Even in the game they lost, the run that scored was an unearned run because of a defensive miscue by Baltimore. Lindor in scoring position, and Kipnis draws a walk. The inning continues, still only one out, and up comes Carlos Santana. You know, get a look at Brandon Hyde there. He's no stranger to Progressive Field. You know, you mentioned the other day, you know, our guy Aaron Boone gets a great job with the Yankees, and Alex Cora gets a great job with the Red Sox. But there still are grinders like Brandon Hyde who spent all that time in the minors, 9 years in the Marlins organization, then 7 years with the Cubs. He was Joe Maddon's first base coach when the Cubs won the World Series here in Cleveland against the Indians in 2016. So he has
paid his dues.
Fond memories of coming to this ballpark.
Sure.
This one probably won't be one of them, though.
No, it will not. But you want to manage. This is how it can happen. But, I mean, you got to hang with him. And his goal is to try and turn this organization around.
So two on, two out. Santana pops one back out of play. Mike Freeman taking over for Jason Kipnis. Missed inside, 2-1. It's 23 of his 45 hits this year have driven in runs for Santana. Low, three balls and a strike. And that's ball four. So now they're loaded. Second straight walk by Enoa. And Carlos Gonzalez coming to the plate.
That's six walks on the day for the Tribe. And Gonzalez still with just one out, an opportunity to add on to a 7-0 lead here.
He drove home a run on the first on a sacrifice fly, walked, scored in the third, struck out his last time up. Now he's trying to blow this baby wide open if it isn't already. And there's a foul ball deep down the right side. You know, I mentioned that last night we look at home and road splits. I was looking at Cargo. He came in today, 12 hits at home, 10 hits on the road, same number of at-bats. Almost dead even.
And could have had two more today or this series.
Yep. Takes a low fastball. And that's a strike call, 1-2. Down at the feet of Cargo, and a good block that time by Wins. Wild pitch led to a run on the third. A pass ball led to a run on the second. An error led directly to another run in this inning. That was by the pitcher, Enoa. Bases loaded, one out, 2-2 pitch. Swung on and missed. And there are two down for Jose Ramirez. Jose Ramirez 0-for-2 with a walk today. Takes a fastball for a strike. Jose 2-for-5 with the bases loaded this year. Smothered by Wins. Well, Jose Ramirez had his first walk-off home run earlier this month. So Well, how about your first career grand slam, too, while we're at it?
Well, he has a count in his favor, 2-1. Just make sure you get one in the strike zone.
Got his fastball, but it was just enough away. Noah came on and has thrown 29 pitches, but almost 50-50. 15 strikes, 14 balls. And the 2-2.
He had him fooled. It was out in front, and he was able to foul it off.
Another high fastball. Didn't get that one up. It was in, and he pulls it foul. Lindor at third. Mike Freeman, the pinch runner, at second. Santana down at first. And the dirt, full count. Sunday afternoon crowd. They want to see some more fireworks. 7-0 Indians on top. But Jose Ramirez with the bases loaded and two out. And a 3-ball, 2-strike count. The runners will be off. And it's ball 4-8-0 Indians. Ramirez will get his 14th RBI. And that is 3 walks in the inning. And that was the 40th pitch thrown in this inning by the Orioles.
Yeah, it's been a long inning for them. The base on balls, killing them. Started off, after you had the first out, had a couple of doubles.
Ninth man to bat is Jake Bowers, 0-for-3. And that's high ball one. And a bouncing ball in the hole. Diving stop by Villar, and he throws him out to end the inning. Boy, heck of a play by Jonathan Villar to get Baltimore out of the inning. But the Indians score 3 more, and they now lead it 8-0. Cleveland Indians baseball is brought to you by your local Toyota dealers. Visit buyatoyota.com. Toyota, let's go places. And by the injury lawyers at Elk and Elk, proud partners of the Cleveland Indians. Call 1-800-ELK-OHIO. Indians on top by a score of 8-0 as we roll now to the 7th. Shane Bieber has punched out 10 today. And that is 9 consecutive first pitch strikes for the right-hander.
Yeah, and he struck out 10 and still at 80 pitches. So he's been very efficient.
0-2.
And this is a guy that's gone down twice. Mancini's gone down twice. Smith has gone down 3 times.
Mike Freeman pinch ran for Kipnis. Stays in at second. Swing and a miss. He struck him out, and that's 11 Ks for Bieber. And for Chris Davis, a series to forget. 2-for-15 with 10 strikeouts.
Well, you just see a fastball, curveball, curveball. See you later.
Stevie Wilkerson punches a single into center field. That's just the fourth hit allowed by Bieber today, and all four hits have been single. Fifth hit of the day. The 2019 FIFA Women's World Cup kicks off June 7th, and all eyes will be on the U.S. Women's National Team. The defending champs head to France, looking for a historic fourth World Cup. All the matches will be live on Fox and FS1. So five hits allowed, all five singles for Bieber, and up comes Renato Nunez. Hasn't walked anybody.
Well, you know, you look at Shane, and it was the long ball that has hurt him. You know, in his first three starts, he had pitched 19 innings and allowed just one home run. But in his last five, when he doesn't have a decision, it was covering 28 two-thirds. He had given up nine home runs.
There's a liner to left. Caught by Cargo. Two down. Well, you kind of had a feeling. Not that the White Sox don't have good hitters and have some guys that with power. They do. But that was just one of those starts, you know, one of those games where the ball was jumping.
You know, it started on that Sunday night start here against
game.
Atlanta.
Yes.
Well, you know,
yes.
He gave up the two when, you know, he thought that Donaldson hit really two good pitches off him. And I don't think it shook
Carl told him the same thing about the ones in against the White Sox. He goes, hey, a couple of those were good pitches that they just beat you
yeah.
on.
My goodness, Moncada hit a changeup out
right.
the other way. That's
yeah,
not going to happen
he
every
pulled
day.
One fastball hit down the line, and then he hit the changeup up next time. So big league hitters can do that to you. I think it was maybe a little a dose of reality for Biebs, but I'll tell you what, this kid, he doesn't back down. He comes right back at you. He's been very aggressive today. Never been in trouble at all. They get their first hit of the game. The next hitter, he gets the double play.
And he's got Ruiz down on the count 0-2.
You know, if he can get this out relatively quickly, he's got a chance if they want him, he can come back in the eighth. But even though it is 8-0.
Swung out and missed. A dozen K's for Shane Bieber. Stretch time in Cleveland. 8-0 Indians. Our Miller Lite Hold True moment. Shane Bieber.
Well, Shane Bieber today, 12 punchouts. And I mean to tell you, good sliders. He had the fastball working. He had them looking. Three straight guys at one point in time took a called fastball. And he's just been in total command of this ball game. He's given up the five hits, all of them singles. Got a double play ball. Well, Shane Bieber back on track looking for his first win. 20 swings and misses today. And I don't know if they're going to bring the bullpen. He could certainly go one more.
Well, 10 times he had a hitter down on the count 0-2. That's how you get to 12 strikeouts.
Yeah,
you just
right.
keep burying him in the count.
And be efficient with it.
For the Indians here in the bottom of the seventh, we'll start where we did in the bottom of the sixth. Yeah, that way, Jordan. Roberto Perez will lead it off. He grounded out his last time up. 1-for-3 with a run scored and a run batted in today. There's a pop foul out of play.
There you go. See, this time he went up and got after that first pitch.
Something. You know, that's it. I'm glad you made that point earlier, though, because that's something that maybe you don't think about when you're talking about not playing every day, being that guy that gets a, you know, spot start here, and when you're in the catcher's role that he was in last year with Yan Gomes playing as well as he did, he didn't play that all that much. So when you're not playing that much, it is when you're the type of hitter he is, which is a patient hitter, and you get that first pitch fastball, maybe you want to get after it, but, well, that's not the kind of hitter I am.
Yeah, he wants to see a pitch, man, just to get the speed or something.
And I talked to him about that in spring training. I said, just to me, I said, just my perception was you took a lot of good pitches early in counts last year. You know, fastballs that maybe look good. And he said that maybe because of the situation he was in, he got caught maybe being a little too patient. And he said, I want to be more aggressive when I get that fastball early in counts, and it's a pitch I can handle. So maybe playing more will get him into that mindset.
The thing of it is, when you're not playing every day and you get maybe one every 5 days like he was getting, it's easy to not be able to swing the bat. I mean, you have to go out there and swing the bat because you really don't know the strike zone. And he's a patient hitter, and he's got a very good eye at the plate.
Yeah, and it's not that you would ever just give away an at-bat, but when you're playing every day, you might go up there and say, if I get a first-pitch fastball, I'm getting after it. Whereas if I'm not playing every day, you're too choosy. You're too picky.
Yeah, and it's easy. I'll tell you what, when you're playing every day, you do give at-bats away. It's easy to do. That's what it takes a while as a young hitter to realize how not to give away at bats. You know, if you're looking for one pitch and you'll swing at the other one when you're not looking for it and you make your out and you sit back there and shake your head like you're talking to yourself, you know, like we saw Ramirez do in this series.
Yeah.
It's hard to do. Playing every day is hard to do, but if you can do it, it's nice when you get at bats up there every single day. You never feel overmatched. Although you won't be going well all the time. You're not locked in every day.
Martin rifles one into right field. That's his second hit of the game. Oscar Mercado. It's been a series of firsts for him. His first major league hit, and was a double. And then today, his first run batted in.
And that was a double. So, yeah, that's back-to-back games he's been able to play. Would have had his first stolen base today had he stayed on the base.
Yeah, that's right. Popped up foul. And that will find the seats. Yeah, think about this. This is his fourth game. He has scored four runs.
You like that? Well, look, that's his key. If he can get on base, he can run. I think he's probably the fastest guy on this ball club. And we haven't had a good chance to see him, but he can get around the bases very well.
Just serves this
baby,
one to right
out,
field, and that will drop for a hit. And if not for a heck of a play, that could have been a real disaster for Baltimore. I don't know how Mancini corralled that, because it looked like it was going to skip past him. And if it had, we would have really gotten to see the speed of Mercado.
Yes, we would have. And you know what? He slipped as he was coming in, and he was very lucky to catch that ball. So give him some credit. But he didn't swing that hard. He just put it in play. See that he didn't follow through. He was just trying to extend through it. He didn't hit it hard enough, but he gets it first. There's a slip.
Ooh.
Oh, and his hyper, extended that knee.
My knee hurts just watching that.
Yeah, he hyperextended that right knee, but the turf gave up, and he's still able to catch it. So first and second now with one out. And Mercado gets his second hit of the day.
Lindor, two doubles, a walk, two runs scored. out of play. Gabriel Ynoa. This will already be the 50th pitch. He came in the game last inning.
Yes, he did. He walked three guys.
Good slow hook, and Frankie way out in front of it. 1-2.
Yeah, the Indians stay with just one, two, three inning going down offensively. That was back in the fifth.
Same pitch. He lays off at this time. 2-2. Chopped to first, and it's off the glove of Davis. Corralled by Alberto, and they just do get him by a whisker at first base for out number two.
That's a really heads-up play by the second baseman, Alberto, to back up Davis, who, you know, it was a do-or-die play for him trying to catch it, but he flipped it up in the air, and then watch him back up. And he's going to have to wait for it to bounce, but he's right there. The pitcher gets over. Really a nice play, and that's a really close play, but I don't think they're going to check it out.
You're going to give Davis an assist on that? You're going to go 3-4-1 on the put out?
Well, I don't know. Let's see what the Kegler. Yeah, the Kegler said yes. He likes those splits down at the alley, so he's going to go 3-4-1.
Oh, they said no. Just 4-1. Oh. Yeah. No assist for Davis.
Yeah. Well, that's fine. I would agree with that.
In hockey, that would have been an assist, but not in baseball.
Yeah. Well, you know, bowling same way.
But it's interesting. And the reason I ask is because, you know, if a pitcher, one comes back to a pitcher and it goes off his glove.
A lot of times they give the assist. Absolutely.
Assist. That's
he deflects it somewhere. I don't know how that. We'll have to ask the Kegler.
All right, so here is the official explanation according to Redbird from official scorer Bob Maver. If you're going to give him an error, then you can't give him an assist. So that means he would have probably given him an error.
Okay, good.
On that play.
Glad to know.
Sneak a gutter ball by the Kegler?
Never. Yeah, we'll get a chance to see him. I think he's off till Tuesday. We'll check with him on Tuesday.
Fouled back. Nothing. Indians on top with two down here in the seventh. Mike Freeman came on as a pinch runner for Jason Kipnis. Kip today had a bunt single and a run scored. Walked his last time up. He's hitting five straight. He's really picked it up. Payoff pitch. All back. This is going to be the eighth pitch of the at bat for Freeman, and number 60 for Ynoa. That's amazing.
It really is. And it'll be two innings of work.
12th batter he's faced, 60 pitches. And Freeman swats one deep center field. Wilkerson back, racing back, way over his head and off the wall. Two more will score. 10-0 Cleveland. Mike Freeman blasting one off the center field wall.
Yeah, and he smoked that ball. He was on him. He fouled a couple of back. And he drives it to left field. So that's going to be five doubles now for the Indians. Look at that. Halfway up the wall. And they're into double digits. 11 hits. They have 10 runs.
Carlos Santana, two hits today, a home run, a couple of runs batted in. That's low, ball one. Here comes Doug Rocail. Miguel Castro just beginning to loosen in the Baltimore bullpen. But I guess that's what happens, Archie. You mentioned it. When you have a game like they did in the opener, where they threw almost 200 pitches.
Yeah, 205. The bullpen. It was 205 total pitches against the Indians, but the bullpen threw at least 130.
I guess it has its effects as you go along, and so they're asking Ynoa. Oh my goodness, I didn't realize this. So Ynoa threw 54 pitches in the first game of the series, so now he's come back with 61 more here today.
And that's like a start. And the bullpen threw 165 pitches in game one. And they're out for some more here, and it's only the bottom of the seventh. They're just trying to get somebody else loose. This is just, he may end up being dead.
Count by inning, a lot. He's thrown a ton of pitches. He's only faced, 11 batters? 10. This will be his 11th batter that he's faced. No. Nice. One.
Well, when you send nine men to the plate, you start getting confused here. And that happened last inning.
This is the 13th batter he has faced. Santana sending one deep to left field, and it's caught at the base of the big wall. Mike Freeman tacks on two more for the Tribe. 10-0 Cleveland.
Today here in Cleveland, 10-0 over the Baltimore Orioles as we head to the top half of the eighth inning. Back here in center field alongside Jensen Lewis, I'm Al Pawlowski. Great to have you here as well. Jensen, today, Shane Bieber, outstanding. The Indians offense, outstanding. Not much negative for the Tribe today.
All this is due to the polos that we've worn today. I hope our front office has realized the offensive explosion. It's due to the garb that we have.
That is expert analysis right there. One Indians more. Live after the game brought to you by Conrad's. Back upstairs we go. Matt and Rick, take it away.
Thanks, Al and Jensen. We'll catch up with you shortly. Right here, Shane Bieber going to work here in the eighth inning. 90 pitches on the afternoon, has struck out 12 Orioles batters. He has yielded just five singles. And a swing and a miss, and a hat comes off. It's 0-2. Hanser Alberto has one of the Orioles' five singles. That came back in the fifth inning. Clouds are darkening, and the wind continues to howl here at Progressive Field. Mike Freeman will throw out Alberto, one down.
Well, grab some friends and enjoy a cold one right here at the ballpark with a $15 district ticket. That's presented by Miller Lite. You'll get a standing room only ticket with your first drink on us. They are available now at Indians.com.
Catcher Austin Wins, 1-for-2 today. The batter.
This afternoon for Shane Bieber, 11-0-2 counts for him. 11 outs on three pitches or less. Into the eighth inning, and he's just at 93. So really efficient outing for Shane. First time he's faced the Orioles in his career. And looking for get his first win at home.
A.J. Cole up in the Cleveland bullpen. Little number up the first baseline. Perez pounces, flips, two down. You mentioned efficiency earlier. That's about as good as you're going
to
see.
Well, this is in his DNA, man. He doesn't like to walk hitters. He comes at you. And you know what? If you're going to beat him, you're going to have to hit him out of a ball game. He's not going to make mistakes and walk you. You just like the makeup. He just hasn't had he's only given up five hits today. And they always rant and rave about how he pitches when you get runners in scoring position. The game doesn't speed up on him, and he's very mature for his age, 23 years old. And I'll tell you what, he's gonna be a fun one to watch grow up right in front of our eyes.
Struck him out looking. What a day for Shane Bieber. A Baker's dozen, 13 punch-outs. The cast is presented by authority of the Cleveland Indians and may not be reproduced or retransmitted in any form, and the accounts and descriptions of this game may not be disseminated without the express written consent of the Cleveland Indians. Miguel Castro enters the game for the Orioles, making his third appearance in the four-game series. He gave up three runs in the opener in just one-third of an inning. Walked a couple of batters, gave up a hit. And then yesterday allowed a run on two hits in his one inning of work. That was the home run hit by Carlos Santana. He'll face Carlos Gonzalez, Jose Ramirez, Jake Bowers here in the eighth. Richie Martin has taken over for Jonathan Villar at shortstop for Baltimore, and Joey Rickard in for Trey Mancini in right field. Cargo looks at a ball down and in. Dwight Smith in left field has that for out number one. Recapping our storylines brought to you by your Northeast Ohio Ford dealers. Trey Mancini came in on a bit of a roll for Baltimore, but Shane Bieber handcuffed him. And I mean, Shane Bieber is the story of the day. 13 strikeouts for Biebs, 8 shutout innings, allowing just 5 singles.
Yeah, what a game today for him. Best by far.
Jose Ramirez 0 for 2 has 2 walks. One came with the bases loaded to drive in a run. Slicing its way foul. 21,377 turned out for the series finale on a warm Sunday afternoon. 86,352 for the four-game series. Many of those folks have headed for the car with the Indians comfortably in front 10-0. That and some rather ominous-looking clouds circling downtown Cleveland as well.
In a 10-0 game, that can make you leave a little bit early, no question.
Oh, Oakland comes in tomorrow for a three-game series. Really good pitching matchups all three nights. 2-2. Swing and a miss. Down goes Ramirez. Carlos Carrasco will go for the Tribe tomorrow, and Brett Anderson, the left-hander for Oakland. Tuesday, it's Trevor Bauer against Chris Bassett. Bassett's ERA is under 2. And the finale on Wednesday, Jeffrey Rodriguez, Frankie Montas going for Oakland.
Yeah, Montas tossed a gem in his last outing a couple of days ago.
Jake Bowers, comebacker to Castro, and a 1-2-3 inning for the Orioles right-hander. We'll go to the ninth, 10-0 Cleveland. Our Pat O'Brien play of the game will feature the exploits of one Shane Bieber.
Boy, as dominant as he has been today, a career-high 13 strikeouts, four of them he has had on three pitches, at 12-0-2 counts, and just in total command, at just 3-2-0 counts. But, I mean, this guy has been dominating today, and with the fastball, the slider, the curve, the change, it's all been working. And it's been his best game by far. Coming in for a CG and possibly a complete game shutout on his own at 98 pitches. Let's hope.
Gets ahead with a first pitch fastball strike. Chase one in the dirt, and it's 0-2. .70 strikes for Bieber, and 0-2, 13th 0-2 count of the day. Tough way to make a living if you're a hitter.
Oh boy, no kidding.
And just a bit outside.
Yeah, it's hard not to swing at that the way he's been,
right?
You know, been around the plate. And this guy, he's had Smith down every time in his at-bats, four times, 0-2. And this guy's an aggressive hitter that tries to put it in play early.
That's outside with the fastball again, 2-2. Struck him out, and that's 14 now for Shane Bieber.
And four times he's able to get Smith. Here comes that good curveball, a spike curve, if you can see as he throws it, and that thing just drops out of the strike zone and nothing but air.
Rounded to third, scooped by Ramirez on the backhand side, two down. Shane Bieber, one out away from going the distance. Chris Davis flailing away at a breaking ball, strike one. Swing and a miss. 0-2 the count. Shane Bieber, his first career complete game shutout, and a career high 15 strikeouts.
Boy, he was something special today. He should be smiling.
The Indians blow out Baltimore 10-0 to take 3 out of 4 in the series. The Indians go to 25-20 on the year, and now they have won 14 of the last 18 against Baltimore. Winning pitcher, obviously, Shane Bieber, 3-2 now on the year. And the loss will go to Jeffrey Ramirez, who is now 0-2 for Baltimore. Orioles leave town 15-31 on the year. 10-0 is the final. We'll be back with some final thoughts right after this.